Hey folks, this is Vince with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and once again we're going to commentate on a game of X-Wing that Vinny and I recently played. As you can see, I am the Rebel Alliance, trying the U-Wing out for the first time. I've got a Gold Squadron pilot, proton torpedoes, guidance chips, extra munitions, and dorsal turret. And I've got another Y-Wing, the exact same thing. I've got a prototype pilot A-wing, auto thrusters, and Chardan refit. No missiles, but minus 2 squad points. Kind of nice. And then last but not least, Body Rook with pivot wing and sensor jammer. I started off on the attack side, though. This was just set up. All right, Vinny, he's got the scum faction, cartel spacer M3A interceptor, heavy Sith interceptor title, mangler cannon. Basically allows you to equip a cannon with that thing. You've got Fen Rao, protectorate starfighter, outmaneuver, and auto thrusters. And last but not least, we've got the Ketsu Onyu, the Lancer class pursuit craft. Gyroscope targeting, veteran instincts, recon specialist, and shadowcaster title. All of that came to 100 points as well. Okay. So, let's get right down to it. Asteroid placement. Now, this is my first time flying the U-Wing, and basically, did I say U-Wing earlier? I might have meant U-Wing. Anyway, this is my first time playing the U-Wing. And basically, my goal here, the Y-Wings don't have Deadeye. I want to use torpedoes with the Y-Wings. But the downside is their pilot skill is so low, the twos, that they would be the first to move and I may not get a target lock. And then the others might swoop in and get in range one and I wouldn't be able to fire them. All right, we're rolling for initiative there because we have some twos. He has a two as well. But so what my plan was, use the A-Wing to get into position within range three of the ship that I want to target, and then use the U-Wing's pilot ability, the guy that I picked, and basically it says that when a friendly ship performs a target lock, it can perform a target lock within range of any 1 to 3 of any friendly ship. So basically my A-Wing can act as a assisted targeting computer, like a beacon midway between the two large, between the ships, like very far apart. So my A-Wing can like sort of piggyback the target lock to my Y-Wings, thereby saving me in action. And then I can take a focus when I get close enough, giving my proton torpedoes a better chance to hit. I mean, I've got the guidance chips to help with that too, but still. Now I'm noticing the camera quality here might be... I'm going to have to clean my camera. I don't know what's going on here. I think maybe the lighting. Let me check my camera real quick while I'm waiting for you. It looks like my camera lens is dirty. Yeah, so I apologize if there's any weird glare or it's just the camera's, if it's the video quality isn't that good. Hopefully, I mean, I can still make out the ships, but it's unusually bright. Let's put it that way. All right, might be able to fix that in post. All right, so the A-Wing's going to move up. Like I said, my goal with the A-Wing is to get him into the action first, so that he's within range 1 to 3 of everybody else. And then I can use the U-Wing's ability to take target locks with the Y-Wings. Even though I'm outside of range 3 of them with the Y-Wings, the A-Wing is close enough to get that target lock for them. All right, so the U-Wing is moving up, taking action. As a formality. I don't think anyone's ever in range on round 1. Very rarely do we ever. Only if someone takes a boost or something like that and goes 5 straight or something. Now, Vinny's list, he was trying the Shadowcaster out for the first time. And Fen Rao, of course, deadly at range 1. He gets a bunch of bonuses. 1 extra attack die, 1 extra defense die. He does not have the title, though, the Protectorate Starfighter title, so he does not get an extra evade, I think, at range 1. Assuming that you're both in arc of each other. I think that's how the card works. But still, Fen Rao is a force to be reckoned with at close range. And basically, his His interceptor there, I mean, it's squishy. It's got one shield and two hull, I believe. So only 3 hit points, but it can equip a heavy cannon, given that title. So for it's a cheap way to get a cannon onto something, but at the same time it's squishy, so it's like a glass cannon kind of thing. All right, so what's going on? And again, I have the game sped up to times two because this particular game went on fairly long. And all my other videos were, not all of them, but my recent ones were times two just to make the video shorter. Okay, so what are we doing here? I guess we're deciding on something. Maybe maneuvers. I think I'm still picking my maneuvers, trying to figure out what I want to do. There we go. I couldn't decide if I wanted to move up with the A-wing and attempt to block the Shadow. I thought the Shadowcaster might be trying to turn left into my ships. That was like my thought, but what if he turned right? Or something like that? I mean, he's got his mobile firing arc pointed toward the camera, toward my other ship, so he could continue going straight here and still fire out of his mobile arc. And he does have a few abilities, I think, that complement the mobile firing arc. The Shadowcaster title being one of them, I believe. And by the way, we fly casually. I don't keep track of Vinny's upgrade cards. He failed to use, I think, one or two of his upgrade cards throughout the game. I might have missed something too here or there. So we fly casually. Just keep that in the back of your mind. I mean, this will give you a good idea as to how the game is played, but at the same time, it's not perfect. All right. Y-wing's moving up. And again, that A-wing is in range 3 of the Shadowcaster, so you can get that target lock. And here comes the U-wing with his. I mean, the U-wing isn't bad. I mean, four shields and four hull? Like, it sounds like a lot, but it's really not. Especially when you start losing shields. Like, you realize, oh, I only got 5 hit points left, or 4 hit points left. Then you're like, I could get destroyed very easily. Fen Rao, especially. All right. So, I had to be a little cautious with him. All right, so the Shadowcaster's turning there. Not what I wanted, because my target locks were on the Shadowcaster. And yeah, all out of arc. I couldn't. I was trying to launch my torpedoes first thing, try and blow them up early. That was the sole strategy behind my build, was to get those torpedoes out and killing stuff. That's what I wanted. All right, so the Shadowcaster's going to be attacking the A-wing, I believe. They're both nines. I've got auto thrusters that'll kick in at some point. And yeah, two evades, no damage. I'd use my token, but that's okay. Now Fen Rao gets to shoot. Range 3. Not bad. 3 hits. And I take, okay, auto thrusters, it's 2 damage. So my A-wing is now shieldless, thanks to Fen Rao. Not off to a good start. And no damage. He has to spend a focus, but no damage. The Y-wings get to shoot. Primary weapon, 2 attack dice. Not going to be a whole lot against an interceptor like that. 4 defense dice. Yeah, it's just nothing. Nothing. The A-wing gets to shoot. Probably at the Shadowcaster. Oh, the U-wing gets to go. That's right. Oh no, the U-wing should have already shot. What's he rolling for? Oh, is you? He might have been rolling for the interceptor. Okay, that's right. Yeah, because that's a two as well. Now my A-wing gets to shoot, and no damage. Okay. So, Vinny's off to a great start, knocking shields off the A-wing. The Y-wings don't have a firing solution. All right, so what's he doing? Oh yeah, gyroscopic targeting. Basically, whenever you perform a 3, 4, or 5 maneuver, you can move the mobile firing arc for free. I think that's at the end of the combat phase, I think. So now it's behind him. So more than likely, he's going to be making a turn here to the right. Which doesn't help my Y-wings at all. And so go the deliberations. Yeah, again, I apologize. The video quality is terrible on this. I don't know what happened. I mean, I am using, I'm not using the world's. It's a. What do I have here? It's HD 32 zoom Canon Vixia HFR 600. It got it for $100. So like, it's not what you would call a professional video camera. I could probably use my DSLR and it'd be a little bit better quality. It's more convenient because the DSLR is really meant for stills, not for video. But anyway, getting back to this. Maneuvers. Trying to make blocks here wherever possible with the A-wing. All right, and the Y-wings are again trying to get within range 3 so they can fire those torpedoes. Now I can take those focuses and, and that would help with the proton torpedoes, assuming I can get a shot off. I've also got dorsal turrets on those Y-wings, so I can still shoot out the sides if I need to, which may be a thing here in a minute. All right, Shadowcaster getting out of range, at least of the Y-wings. Here comes Fen Rau getting out of there. Taking a focus. Okay. Now the interceptor here is in deep trouble, I think. I mean, he's surrounded by 3 ships that can attack it. All right, so he's taking a focus. I rolled enough evade. The A-wing is safe. Fen Rau doesn't have a shot. Here comes the 4 making a shot on the interceptor. 4 attack dice. Took a 0 here, so target lock. 3 hits, I think. He only got one hit on that. That's ridiculous. Like his evade rolls were crazy this game. All right, so dorsal turret, 3 hits, and he's out. Okay, he got an evade there, but he stays there though because of the simultaneous fire. Both of our pilot skills are 2s, so my second Y-wing is going to take a shot at Fen Rau, and then his interceptor will get a chance to fire before he gets off the board. Yeah, I didn't use my focus there. I was going to use it for defense. I didn't know which Y-wing his interceptor would attack, or possibly my U-wing for that matter. All right, so now his interceptor gets to shoot one last time before it gets put off the board. And I was just giving him the damage cards from the earlier shot, just to show the folks at home that he did take enough damage. And I got 2 hits. Did 2 damage to one of the Y-wings. Okay, so before the interceptor kicked the bucket, he did manage to put a dent in one of the Y-wing shields. All right, so we've got two scum ships and four rebel ships. Things are looking good for the Alliance. The Y-wings are in nice formation there. But still, Fenn Rahl is a force to be reckoned with, and the Shadowcaster still has a lot of shields left. Could be anyone's game. Check-in maneuvers. Using the wrong dial. Yeah, once ships start going off the board, we end up using the wrong dial sometimes. Yeah, we try and catch ourselves. We're like, I'm looking at the dial and I'm like, how come this A-wing can't do a three straight green? I'm like, oh, it's a Y-wing. Okay, Y-wing dial. I can't. Oh, no wonder. All right, so one turn there, taking an evade. Nothing fancy. Moving up with the Y-wings, just again trying to get into torpedo range, taking the focus. Trying to stay in formation. Here comes Fenn Rahl, more than likely. And the Shadowcasters. Yeah. And that's a green maneuver, I think, too. That's crazy. Yeah, I still don't have a fire. He's just staying out of range of my Y-wings. He's doing a very good job of that. I've been trying to get a beat on him this entire game with the Y-wings, and I can't do it. And meanwhile, here comes Fenn Rahl, range one on the U-wing. Not a good thing. Lots of special ability. That's five attack dice, if I'm not mistaken. He's taking a focus. One for range one for his ability. Three by default. All right, so that's okay. I'm using my sensor jammer to turn a hit into a focus, and he's saving his focus for defense. Or yeah, for defense, because I'm rolling four attack dice myself. He could have spent his focus there and gotten a few more hits. I think three, but he did not want to get wiped off the board. All right, his Shadowcaster's attacking. I got enough evade on my A-wing. No damage done. Now my four should go next. Yep, against Fenn Rahl. Four attack dice against his three. His auto thrusters don't work here. Give me something good. Target lock. Three hits. Three evade, no damage. Probably should have spent the focus, but it was a good precaution. Hit and blank. Auto thrusters kicked in. Yeah, he's two hits. Auto thrusters and an evade. Yep, no damage. A-wing doesn't have a shot. Nothing. Nothing. I mean, it could have been worse for the U-wing with five attack dice, so I lucked out there. Those blasted Y-wings. Come on, get into range. I mean, on the plus side, his Shadowcaster, because I'm chasing it around the board, it's one less ship that's not going after my U-wing. Like, I'm sort of like separating their ships and preventing a focused fire kind of thing going. But, you know, he's got that mobile firing arc, so he can continue shooting out the side if he wanted to while he's strafing around the edges of the board. Sort of like the Millennium Falcon can. All right, so what is my A-wing gonna do? I had a choice. Do I go after the Shadowcaster or do I go after Fenn Rahl? All right. Taking an evade, possibly. All right, two hard turn with the Y-wings. And again, two focus. There we go. And here comes the U-wing, moving past Fenn Rahl, trying to close in on the Shadowcaster. He's doing a 4K turn with the Shadowcaster. Stressful maneuver, but he's got a shot on the U-wing now. And the Shadowcaster more than likely making another three maneuver. Yeah, he loves those three maneuvers. Behind an asteroid, which is good. That'll give them an extra defense. It looks like two asteroids in some cases. All right, Shadowcaster gets first shot, so does Fenrao. Range 3. Not through an asteroid to the Y-wing on the left, from the looks of it. Closest base to closest base. Those two corners there. All right, so Shadowcaster is making a shot at the Y-wing, I think. Yep, blanks. So I take two damage cards there on the Y-wing furthest from the camera on the left. Three hull left on that one. And now Fenrao takes a shot. He gets three attack dice, one crit from the looks of it, one evade, no damage. Okay, so Fenrao doesn't do anything there. Now my four goes attacking. Huh? Missed the asteroid, that's good. Three attack dice versus two defense dice. Unless it's range 3. It's range 2, okay. One shield gone. He got two of 8 on that. Again, his evade rolling skills here were excellent. All right, Proton Torpedo, finally. What I was looking for. Four attack dice, range 3. Not through an asteroid. Guidance chips. And I turned one into a hit. So I got three hits. And one of eights. That's two shields gone off the Shadowcaster. So the Shadowcaster is now shieldless. I believe it has seven hulls, so it's still in the game. The other Y-wing does not have a firing solution. A-wing now taking a shot at Fenrao through an asteroid. One hit. He's caught enough. Yeah, he's fine. Fenrao is not taking any damage. Okay, back to the dials again. Fenrao's in a pretty good position here to close in on somebody and inflict some damage. All right. Trying to decide what to do now. If I'm not careful, that Y-wing will run into that asteroid, so I need to make a bank here without wrecking into my other Y-wing. The A-wing trying to block the Protectorate, probably. That's the nice thing about moving first. I mean, granted, the lower combat or the lower pilot skill means you shoot last, but if you can successfully block your opponent. And what do I do? Probably take either a focus or an evade here. An evade, okay. And Y-wing's moving up. Bump. Take in another target lock. I still have extra munitions, so I mean, I got another proton torpedo on that far side Y-wing there. U-wing's moving up. Trying to get some shots off. All right, moving three. Still an arc of the U-wing. Which is good news for me, but he gets to shoot first. Oh, his Fenrao still gets to go. He's getting two focus because of recon specialist. For those of you that are wondering why his Shadowcaster keeps getting two focus tokens, and he does bump my A-wing here, so no action. I knew he would be going straight more than likely because he had stress on him. All right, so who's he shooting? Oh, he's shooting at my Y-wing. I lost some shields. Three shields gone on the other Y-wing, the one closest to me. Or to the camera, I should say. So both Y-wings are shieldless. One has two damage on it. Shadowcaster's making a shot. Wow. I lose. Yeah, the sensor jammer didn't do anything. He spent a focus. That's three damage. I lose three shields on my U-wing. I've got one shield left and four hull on that. So each ship is slowly going down here. All right, shooting back. That's two damage. Yeah, two damage on the Shadowcaster. Again, he got two evade on that roll. Him and his evades. Proton torpedoes making a shot through the asteroid. This is my extra munitions kicking in. I dropped it on the floor. All right, so one focus goes into a hit, I think. And my guidance chips turns the other one into. Okay, so I've got four hits here. He's got two evade. Still very good. So I think that's a crit and a hit. Damage cockpit. Starting the round after this one. Oh, he's got three evade. Okay, so he only takes the one crit, which is ridiculous. Again, him and his evade rolls. I don't know how he's doing it. He's got loaded dice, I swear. So the Y-wing that's damaged has no more torpedoes left. The other one hasn't even fired their torpedoes. I'm hoping to make use of them soon. Okay. I think the Y-wings tried shooting at Fen Rao, and the one closest to me tried shooting dorsal turret. Fen Rao didn't work. Okay, and the A-wing obviously doesn't have a shot. It's touching Fen Rao. All right, he's using his ability again, turning his mobile firing arc toward the center, which is a good indicator as to where he may go. But my Y-wings aren't exactly agile enough to do much about it. And my U-wing is definitely pointed in the wrong direction. Now, just as a reminder, the U-wing has two a dual side title card. One side gives it an extra agility. The other side lets it do a 180 zero turn. Like it's like a K turn, but at zero speed, which is really cool. But after you execute a maneuver, you flip the card to the other side. It's like adaptability. It has two sides. All right, so he's moving in here. Dangerous. But now my other Y-wing can't shoot proton torpedoes because it's a range 2 to 3 secondary weapon. All right, so 3K turn here with the A-wing. Each of the Y-wings are going one straight here. Too close for the proton torpedo on the one, but I can still get a few shots off, possibly. Dorsal turret or primary weapon, at least. And unfortunately, the U-wing is just not an arc. It's going to take him a while to get back around. Taking a target lock, though, for future rounds. And did Fen Rao go? No, I think Vinny catches this. Yeah, he Vinny caught it. Yeah, that's even better for him. Fen Rao has outmaneuver as well, and without maneuver, your opponent loses one agility, and the Y-wing has one natural. So I couldn't roll any defense dice here. So I was at the mercy of whatever he rolled, which was three hits. Which destroyed, I think, yep, destroyed that Y-wing on the far side. So he's got one Y-wing off the board now. All right, now a Shadowcaster gets to shoot. Or it should be. He's got four attack dice. Shouldn't he be attacking with the Shadowcaster? Unless he did already, I'm not sure. Unless we just missed it altogether. All right, so we got a damage card, major explosion, rolled a hit, another crit. Basically, you roll for damage, and if you get a hit, you get another face-up crit. And finally, the second crit was receive a stress token, then flip this card face down. So he got two hits there. Oh, I think I know why. The Shadowcaster, I think, got that. Did the Shadowcaster get that? During the game, it got a critical that gave it a pilot skill of zero, and I'm wondering if that's why it hasn't shot yet. All right, so it looks like some damage was done to my Y-wing. Yeah, I think that's what that was. I must have missed that during the commentary here. If we see a Shadowcaster moving first here, we'll know that that's the case because, yeah, we'll see. All right. Again, this is a double speed, and we're already at the 30-minute mark. So, like I said, this was a fairly intense game. Normally, the games are over by now at 2x speed. This would have been an hour long, plus, if it were a normal. Yeah, he moved first, so he definitely. That's why he didn't shoot earlier. Right away. It was because he had pilot skill of 0. So here comes the Y or the A wing, pilot skill 1. Y wing, pilot skill 2, moving. Just trying to get out of there and turn around so I can start launching some torpedoes or something. Part of me is wondering if I should have done a 4K turn. All right, did not bump. There's still some leeway there. All right, he crashes into my Y wing. So the U wing and the Fen Rao are once again head to head. Gonna get nasty. Fen Rao's gonna take a shot. 5 attack dice. And he's got 2 hits, I think. I must have taken damage. 1 shield. Only 1 hit. Yeah, I'm surprised. Fen Rao didn't get any actions because he bumped. Had he had actions, he probably would have done better. Alright, and no damage, I think. Fen Rao's rolling. Again, extra defense die at range 1. Y-Wing using dorsal. Should I have not rolled an extra one? Oh no, the Y-Wing was bumping. So I think I was attacking the Shadowcaster. Yeah, I must have been. All right. And the Shadowcaster is off the board. Compliments of the A-Wing, the pilot that I least suspected would take out a Shadowcaster. Awesome job. Like, the A-Wing was just there as a scout for the U-Wing's ability. I was not expecting him to actually be as useful as he was. Question is, can he finish off Fen Rao now? That's the question. Fen Rao is. Now, I'm showing him here. He had questions about the 2-talon rule, and I'm showing him how that works. So that's what that was. Vinny gets a little careless with the hands. He's Italian, he's got to move them. Okay. So the game looks like it's over. I mean, one ship, one scum ship versus 3 rebel ships. One Y-Wing's got torpedoes. Looking good. Looks can be deceiving. But I guess we'll see. All right, so the A-Wing moving in behind Fen Rao. Taking a focus, I think, this time. Yep. We played earlier, so I still have some memory of the game. Not a lot, but some. And I flipped my U-Wing card title over to the landing side so I could possibly do a 180 on the next turn. And here he is doing a 2-talon roll. Now, my Y-Wing went 1 forward and bumped my U-Wing. Probably a bad move on my part, because now he's at range 1 of the Y-Wing's going to blow me up. It's not going to feel too good. And he's got outmaneuver because I'm outside of arc, so I can't roll any defense dice. So that was a great maneuver on Vinny's part. Had I done a 0 there with the U-Wing, I would have been okay. So I got 2 crits with that roll and a face down damage card. So I had 1 hit left. Console fire and loose stabilizer. Yeah, the Y-Wing is on its death throes. That's all I'm saying. All right, here comes the A-wing. Looks like he takes a direct hit. Oh, it was a crit that was a direct hit. So the A-wing again, being the MVP of the game so far, just doing very well. Was not expecting this. And we're deliberating over dials as usual. It's a good thing we have this sped up by two, otherwise we'd be in for a long wait. This is the longest part of the game right here, is figuring out what we want to do next. Will he move here? And if he does, what should I do? But what if he doesn't do that? What if he moves here? Then what am I going to do? So which one do I pick? Do I go this way? Do I go that way? Do I just do something completely different to throw him off? You know, it's all of these things. That is what makes X-Wing so great. You never know what your opponent's going to do despite your best laid plans. I mean, my best laid plans with the Y-Wings were to stay in formation and launch those torpedoes, but you saw how well that worked out. My one Y-Wing still has a full load of proton torpedoes and extra munitions, and he's one shot away from being killed. All right, so it's a 5K turn here with the A-Wing. 4K turn here with the Y-wing. And here comes the Protectorate now. What's he gonna do? All right, now admittedly, one thing I forgot to do here. At the beginning of the combat phase, I was supposed to roll for damage on the Y-wing. I did not do it, so I did catch that here, but not in game. I don't think it mattered anyway, but we'll see. Yeah, the target lock should have been on the U-wing, I think. Our target lock sort of got mixed up, so I put it back on the U-wing. I don't think there was any damage there. Nope. Fen Rao's holding on with 2 health. Should have rolled for damage there. Again, combat phase on the Y-wing. And the board is a mess. Stress tokens abound. Some of them shouldn't be there. At this point, we were like, just, okay, there we go, I'm cleaning up. Okay. Yeah, once we get into like the half an hour mark, we start losing it, like making mistakes, getting sloppy. And that was a straight maneuver, so I should have gotten a stress there. Should have gotten a stress. Again, that was per the. Now, that might have been. No, that was a green maneuver. So, no stress. So that wasn't that big of a mistake. All right, Fen Rao's taking a shot on who? Probably on the Y-wing. No, I think he might have shot at the A-wing. All right, no damage done there either. Again, forgot to roll for con you know for the Y-wing's for the Y-wing's damage card on a hit, suffer 1 damage. Should have done that. My bad. My bad. Alright, so here comes the A-wing with the block. We're trying to. Alright, Y-wing's coming in hot. That might have been a white maneuver, so that focus was questionable. Unless, I think that if it was a one slight turn, it might have been a green maneuver. Okay, he bumps here. Takes the shot on the Y-wing. Okay. And the Y-wing is blown up. Okay, so at best, he could have made a shot here at my U-wing. Whether or not he would have hit, I don't know. Had the Y-wing had I blown up the Y-wing via a bad roll from the damage card, he would have had a shot on the U-wing here. And it looks like Vinny took another damage. So he's got th one hull left. He's hanging on for dear life. Now we're into 40 minutes. Yeah, th this was, again, a very long game. And again, this is double speed, folks. Double speed. This is why. This is why it's hard sometimes to make X-Wing videos, because sometimes our games run long like this. But with good reason. I mean, it started getting. Like, at first, it seemed like I was winning, and then all of a sudden, Fen Rao just shows up and is like, nope. You're dead. You're dead. Not gonna spoil the rest for you. All right, 3K turn with the A-wing. Trying to get a firing solution. That's a red maneuver, so I get stressed. Barely missing the asteroid there. Not sure if that's what I really wanted to do. Probably should have gone forward with it over the asteroid. I guess I need to get over my fear of going over asteroids. At most, I'd lose the damage and not take an action, but I could have blocked him here, and he wouldn't have gotten a shot on me. He got five attack dice. That's two damage. Yeah, see, I took two damage on the U-wing. I had two damage left on that. So I think that was a poor choice on my part. I should not have done a turn there. All right, no damage with the A-wing. And what will Vinny do? Now, Vinny doesn't have a whole lot of options here. I mean, he's got to either fly left or try and fly past the U-wing. I don't think a one straight would do anything except bump into me. So I was like, you know what? Maybe I should just do like a zero. I think that was the right idea here. All right. Again, the A-wing being the aggressor here. Did a zero. Okay, now it looks like he's turning that way. So the only shot, the only one of the shot is the A-wing. Again, just two dice, target lock, blank. Ugh, one hit. No damage, as usual. But the A-wing again has proven itself to be very useful. Two ships versus one. Who's gonna win? And this, ladies and gentlemen, is where things get bad. Critical hit. Double damage. Direct hit. Dead. I misjudged the asteroid. I thought I could fit, but I didn't. So my A-wing just careened right into the asteroid, took a critical on the roll, and then it was a direct hit. So, with two hull left, my A-wing died. So, immediately, because of my stupidity, I lost a ship. So now it's one versus one. My U-wing has two hits left to it. His protectorate starfighter has one. So now all of a sudden, the odds don't look so bad for Vinny. I mean, he went from three ships to one. So he's like, Fen Rao is just on top of things here. All right, now this is a good shot for me if I can land it. Three hits. He's got to roll three evade. Which he does. Which he does. Three evade. You got to be kidding me. I had him right there. But again, his those green dice, he's working some like voodoo magic or something, 'cause he's got like evade after evade after evade on these rolls. Sorcery, I tell you, sorcery. Either that or the scum faction has found a way to like channel into Vinny, and he's like fixing and manipulating the dice. I'm gonna have to weigh these dice later and see if maybe he's done something to them. I don't know. All right, so here I am bumping, I think. And he's getting out of there. And I don't think we have a firing solution on each other, so looks like he's trying to boost but doesn't fit. His base would barely land on the asteroid. All right, so he's taking a target lock instead. All right, so it's coming down to the wire here. Two ships with two target locks on each other, and he's got the higher pilot skills, so he gets to shoot first, making me nervous. I gotta focus now. He's doing a K turn. We're at range three. He's got a stress though. He got a target lock, but that's about it. So he's got three attack dice. I've got three defense dice. I gotta hope. All right, he's got two hits. I've got one evade and a focus. I could cancel out the damage, but I decide to take the damage. So that's one hit. I'm down to one hull. Saving the focus for offense. Trying to get rid of him here. Spending my focus. I got two focus on that roll. Vinny did not get enough evade there. One hit. Knocked it through. Ugh. If I had, I not saved that focus token, I think he would have won that game. I think he would have won that game because, that on the next turn he would have gotten the first shot, probably at close range, and I would have been dead. So there you go, folks. A very, very, very good game. Vinny did an excellent job, playing with the scum faction. He's getting better and better every time I play him. But if you guys want to see more gameplay, let me know. If you guys haven't already, subscribed to my channel and check out my official website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vince. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.